Jagdish Taitla, senior Congress leader against whom the case has been reopened yesterday and now is a subject of discussion and controversy nationally, joins me live on the NewsHour. Mr. Jagdish Taitla, welcome. Many people are now saying, especially...
Can you put the volume just a little higher?
Yeah, you can hear me, Mr. Taitla?
Put the volume up. Put the volume up, please.
You can hear me, Mr. Taitla?
Very, very faintly. Just put the volume up, please.
Absolutely. I wouldn't want you to not hear me. Is that better?
Yeah, that's what I see outside, not in my ear. Yeah.
I'll tell you, you will hear me loud enough. Mr. Taitla, many people, including lawyers on the other side, feel now that that you should be put up to a lie detector test. Besides this investigation which is going on against you, given the tall claims that you're making, that you should be made to face a lie detector test.
Well, I think before you come out with these questions, I would like to ask you two things. Because I saw you yesterday, the way you condemned me, and then you suddenly became you started talking about them. Do you know the case? Do you know the case history? It's very important.
Mr. Taitla, I want to tell you one thing very clearly right at the start. Do not try to be aggressive with me. Don't try to patronize me.
No.
Don't try to lecture me. You are I am asking the questions. You are asking the answers. You are giving the answers, I presume.
I agree with you. That is why I have come.
Good.
That is why I have come.
Good. Good.
I just want to tell you this thing because this is a question of my life and you made it hell for me yesterday.
Mr. Taitla, I want
you to know the truth.
Mr. Taitla, I'm sorry to be direct with you.
Let me answer you this thing.
Mr. Taitla, one second. You haven't even faced a question yet. You are getting nervous. I haven't even asked you a question.
No, please don't say this. No, don't say. You may get away by telling other people, I'm nervous. I'm not nervous. Okay. I want to tell you this thing. Let me ask you first question. I am prepared for a live test and the witness and Mr. Phulka. Would you agree on this?
Are you? I thought you don't want
to
appear on
Phulka
TV with Mr.
and
Phulka.
Myself and the witnesses on the live detecting test?
I am told that you are avoiding a television debate with Mr. Phulka.
I'm prepared to take a debate and I say you should be in Delhi and you conduct this debate. But I want to tell you this, I want to go for a lie detecting test and Phulka should also go and all the new witnesses have come also should go.
Okay.
I'm prepared for that.
So Mr. Taitla, I wanted to talk one to one with you. You said I want to debate with Mr. Phulka. So here's Mr. Phulka. Mr. Phulka is live with us tonight.
No,
don't say
you
now you don't want
Mr.
to debate
Phulka
with Mr.
Phulka. Separately. No, listen to me.
Why are you avoiding it now?
I want you...
Why are you avoiding it?
Is
you
Mr.
said
Phulka
it right
ready
now.
Ready for a lie detecting test?
You said I want to debate with Mr. Phulka.
Test?
Here is Mr. Phulka. Will you debate him or will you run away from that debate?
I want to know the question. Is he ready for a lie detecting test?
Are you ready for a lie detector test, Mr. Phulka?
Yes, I am not an accused, but at the same time, I am ready for any kind of test. Any kind of test.
Let's both put an application to the CBI.
Yes.
Let's put an application to the CBI and we will both go for a test and your witnesses. Let the truth come out. You have had
Mr.
enough
Taitler,
time.
The witnesses, there is no system.
You have played.
There is no system. Mr. Taitler, by using your political pressure, till now you have made these victims as the accused. There is no system under the law to put the witnesses under the light detector.
People.
It is the accused.
You can impress
it is you
the
who will go. It is you
that
who will go.
He made a statement 164.
It is not
that
a,
you are a fraud and you
Mr. Taitler, I impressed the court
you
also.
You made those false certificates. I
impress the court also, not only the television people, because I am right on law.
Surinder, I am right on facts. They are prepared to come and tell you that how you used
Mr. Taitler, you are bringing their affidavits in 2008. You have brought that Surinder Singh's father affidavit and shown to the media. You are in touch with the victims.
Are you in touch? No, no, are you trying to influence the witnesses? One second, gentlemen.
Why were you not there? Why did you not come that time?
I was right from very beginning. You have been telling them the TV channel there's no allegations against you and Nanavati. Absolutely lie. Allegations against you right from day one. Much before even I came into picture.
Nanavati is gone on record. With
Mr. Titler, there were allegations against you from first week of November 84.
Arnab.
Yes.
Arnab.
Yeah.
Arnab.
Yeah.
Arnab, would you please listen to me? I wanted a debate with you and I want a separate debate right in front of my face with this man. And you being there.
Okay, so here's what we'll do. Okay, one minute.
Or he has frauded the document.
One minute.
I want to ask him.
Okay, ask
I want to ask him, ki when he made the first affidavit, did the papers were bought by Surinder Singh or you bought the papers?
Mr. Titler, I was
who
not
bought
even
the
there.
Papers for Surinder Singh?
I didn't know. I do not even know who. Mr. Titler, if you know.
Surinder Singh has gone on record. I have his recording. He has gone on record to say Surinder that you Singh, made him sign here, this and he doesn't know anything.
Here is. Mr. Titler, this is the Surinder Singh's statement before Nanavati Commission. Surinder Singh, before the Nanavati Commission.
But he made two statements. And second one, he says that I did not make the statement.
One minute. What did Nanavati say? One minute, gentlemen. What did. Yes, sir. Mr. Titler, you are saying he made two statements. Key witness Surinder Singh, you are saying he made two statements. You are right, but you're only partially right. One minute, Mr. Titler. Let me complete. You said you want me to ask questions.
This is the statement before Nanavati, where he named Jagdish Titler here.
Okay.
Before Nanavati when he appeared.
Okay.
And Titler is saying I got the paper signed by defrauding him. When he appears before Nanavati Commission,
but,
this is what he
please,
says.
Please show the second affidavit.
Titler.
Please show the second affidavit. Please show the second affidavit.
The second affidavit.
Please show the second affidavit which he wrote in Gurumki.
To the CBI. Mr.
I said, would you show the second certificate
now,
which he gave to the CBI?
No, no, I'll tell you what is in the second affidavit. One second. Mr. Titler. Mr. Titler asks, show the second affidavit. I would tell Mr. Titler the second affidavit. First affidavit says, by the way, and Mr. Titler, if I have any factual inaccuracy, stop me right here. Otherwise, accept that what I'm saying is right. First affidavit, he says, I saw Jagdish Titler leading and inciting a mob that killed Sikhs on November 1st, 1984. Second affidavit, in August 5th, 2002, he says that I saw the mob that attacked Gurdwara Pulbangash. Police people were saying the attack was led by Congress leaders, but in the mob, I did not see Jagdish Titler anywhere. That's what he says. But now, one second. Here is what the Nanavati Commission says. The Nanavati Commission says in his report, scathing on you, it says, what appears from all of this is that the subsequent affidavit was probably obtained by persuasion or under pressure. If this witness had really not seen Jagdish Titler in the mob, or if he was not approached by Titler, then he would not have come before the commission to give evidence, or would have told the commission that the attack did not take place in that manner. For speaking the truth, it was not necessary for him to wait till the 5th of August 2002 and file an additional affidavit. In other words, Nanavati Commission did not accept the retraction at face value, right or wrong.
Okay, that is why he wanted an inquiry to be done.
No,
I'm not denying that inquiry should not be done. I'm not saying that inquiry should not be done.
Inquiry should
be done. The truth must come out.
But you must
see Surinder Singh's statement also later on to the CBI.
One second, Mr. Titler, I'm asking you
to... Can you read the statement to the CBI?
I'll say it on record. I believe that on other news channels, you have not been questioned on fact. I'm going to question you on fact. And this is what the Nanavati Commission said about Titler.
What are you talking?
This is what the Nanavati Commission said about Titler. One second, Mr. Titler.
Can documents be brought?
Mr. Titler.
No, wait, I'll get the documents. I brought the documents here.
I've also got the documents. Mr. Titler, Mr. Nanavati Commission said, relying upon
No, you also say what he told the CBI. What did he tell the CBI?
What did the Nanavati Commission say?
Surinder Singh said since some of the CBI.
He tells the CBI here.
Go to the Prime Minister.
He tells the CBI here.
Surinder Singh also gave to the court.
Mujhe aaj Gurmukhi.
Can you get me the documents?